6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Other side. can just stay here halfway, or you can fold all the way. If this is new to you, I suggest just fold halfway and up. And then let's do 10 times. And fold and up. Fold and up. Fold and up. And a couple of more on your own. Complete the 10 repetitions. And then stop, rest, breathe. Now we move on the left.
We will need a chair.
the knees don't go over the toes. But also bring your arms behind the head so that you are not slouching. You are teaching your body to be on an upright position. And ready, and one, up. It's fine if you really sit down on the chair. And two, and three. And then keep pressing from the heels when you come up. Four, and five, six, I'll just look at it. Seven, eight, nine, and 10. If you notice, when I go up, I make a point to the knees are straight and the hips are open. You can do that 15 more, 15 reps. And then repeat it 3 times. But you have to rest in between so that you're giving your legs to recover. Okay, next. So that is the first. Next exercise. Again, for the first, that is squat on the chair. Alignment of the knees, and then bringing your buttocks back, and then opening, making the knees straight, and open up your hip when you come. 15 repetitions, and then repeat it 3 times. Then second exercise. Okay, we'll work on the back leg. So if you don't have, if this is new to you and you're very, and your balance is not that good, I suggest you hold on to the wall, just like what I did earlier. Hold on to the wall. Let's start with the right leg. This is the right wall. With the left arm, hold on to the wall. Hands on the hips. Or you can lift the arm, right arm up. Inhale and exhale, fold halfway. Make sure your heel is flat and then your toes are pointing down. And up, I'll just do 10, fold, and inhale up, exhale, fold, inhale up, you're feeling work on this part of your body, fold, and up, fold, and up, okay, turn for your breath work, inhale up, exhale, fold, inhale up, exhale, fold, inhale up, exhale, fold. So that is what you call single leg deadlift. It works out the back side of your neck. It's a major muscle. You can do 15 repetitions per leg. And then 3 times first, 3 sets first on the first leg, rest. And then do the rest on the second leg. Okay. Now for the last exercise, we will focus on your chest. The back, you can do that later on. You can just add the back later on. Because when you do the squat and the legs, you're also working your back and your core. So for the last, we'll focus on the chest. If push-up is new to you, you can use the wall or you can use the chair. I'll give you an option. For the wall, your palms are open wide, your pointer finger is pointing up, and then your thumbs are facing each other. So that when you bend, the elbows are bending towards the back of the room. It's not pushing on the side. Pushing on the side, or when your elbows bend sideways, it's bad for the joint. Okay, so when you do it on the wall, I have to turn my back on you. Pointer finger up, and then step one to two steps away from the wall, and from here, bend and up. Bend and up. Keep reminding yourself to always tuck your belly in so that you are not hyperextending or you're not collapsing. And from there, you can do 10 reps. If you're able to finish 10 repetitions, rest. And for this one, you have to do 4 sets. If you can reach 5 sets, much better. So that's our workout for today. Hope you will enjoy.